Hey, I'm Carrie. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome for the first time. All around, welcome. I'm Carrieblogger, a career freelancer on Fiverr.com, where I've been selling as a Fiverr Pro verified copywriter for about the past 7 years now. And in today's Freelance Friday video, I am talking about how to limit orders, particularly how to manage your time, how to not get overbooked, overworked, and to scale up your momentum in a way that is sustainable and appropriate without losing out on your own opportunities. This has been weighing on me for several weeks now, well, for years. And this has also been come up in a couple comments. As always, if you have a topic you'd like me to touch on, please feel free to comment that down below. I can't always guarantee that I will talk about it, but I do try. And while you're at it, please be sure to like and subscribe because you are helping my tiny channel grow and I so appreciate it. So thank you. So keeping a lid on things, it is the best kind of problem to have. I do realize that I have so much privilege. My business is fantastic. I'm so blessed and lucky, and I've been in the right place in the right time for a lot of things. I don't know. I just want to say thank you to the people who have ordered from me and supported me. I do appreciate it. And I know that as I talk about limiting orders, keeping a lid on things, not getting too overwhelmed with work, that is a fantastic problem to have, a rare problem to have. And I approach the subject with as much humility and gratitude as I can. So, disclaimer. Like all of my videos, this is basically a case study on myself, my own business, completely based on my own experience. So in today's video, I'm going to be talking about like two reasons I realized I needed to change, six strategies of how I have limited my work and how I can limit my work, I think, and then six things that I've noticed after I've made a couple of those changes. The last one on the list, so stick around till the end, is a little bit of like sales psychology. All right, let's get into it. I've done enough talking. Here we go. Number one was I'm just too busy. That's not healthy. It's not sustainable. I typically, in my perfect workflow, like to have two orders a day. And with those two orders a day, that allows me to work between 1 to 4 hours. And of course, it scales. It's flexible. When I'm continually over two orders, it's not meeting my own personal level of comfort. I'm just too goddamn busy. The other reason that I knew I needed to change something was because I didn't have enough flexibility. So recently, sales have been more surging. So instead of getting kind of a consistent few orders every day, I've been getting like one day where I get 8 or 10 orders and just really, really popular. And then it will kind of die down a little bit for a couple days and it's been surging. With a 5-day delivery period hasn't allowed me the amount of flexibility I need to be able to parcel it out. So I was considering changing to a longer delivery period so that the surge isn't quite so noticeable to me because I just have more time in order to spread all of those out more consistently. Now the how. How do you just stay manageable? How do you do it and continue to deliver at the highest level for every customer and continue to build positive things without letting any negative slip in through the cracks? The first one is just to tell people no. And I'm trying. I'm really bad at it. Usually before, if someone says, you know, I need this, and I say, well, I can help with part of that, or maybe I can blah, 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 I've just started saying no. Number two is full panic mode. And I do that sometimes. I've been doing it more often now. And that's when I reach the breaking point and I say, I cannot, can't do this anymore. I need a week off. And I turn everything off. I go on vacation mode, out of the office, no work. And I usually do that for about a week, week and a half. But the problem with that also is, well, A, you're not working at all, so that's not really building anything, it's not sustainable. And two is that you still have to work through everything in your queue. So I have to decide that I've hit my breaking point 5 days before my actual breaking point, because I still have 5 days worth of work before I'm actually free to go on vacation. Number three is to raise your prices. I used to do this every time I got overbooked for myself. In the early days especially, I was just doubling. Anytime I got overworked, I would double my prices because I was selling at such low rates anyway, and I felt like that was very fair and reasonable. And it also, anytime I raise my prices, I do so with the knowledge or like self-reassurance that what I am doing is valuable. Even if I don't get as many orders, which is kind of the goal, that the price increase will keep me at the same level or allow me to earn more than I was previously. That might sound really stupid because that's how raising your prices works. You earn more for less work. Now that's more difficult because I'm at such a high price point. When I break it down and I can't just double, it's just harder to break down how much I can add, where I can add it, where it's valuable to do so. And I also want to be sensitive to the budgets of my clients and also just the world at large, especially with so many people being furloughed right now and the economy being in flux. I don't want to outprice myself to the point where it's not viable for people to work with me. But again, I'm at such a high price point compared to the rest or the majority of the market on Fiverr that y'all probably have a much easier time convincing yourself it's okay and reasonably doing it to raise your prices according to the value that you're delivering. I have to be a little bit more cautious of that now and really think through how that's possible. Number four is to limit orders in queue. There's actually a tool for that in the gig section, but I have not seen it work. I don't really get how it works or why. I feel like I remember it working differently. Theoretically, I have put it so that I can only have 3 orders in queue for each of my writing gigs at a single time, but it doesn't actually stop people from ordering. It just says overbooked. I still send custom offers to people to order and they still can't. So it hasn't stopped me from being an idiot and just continuing to pile more work on myself. And it hasn't stopped random people from visiting my gig and ordering. So I don't know what it does. And it also doesn't take into account the size of order. If I send a custom offer for 1 $20 product description, and I also have an offer where someone ordered times 5 of a package, like those are very different things and very different amount of time. So the overbooked limiting gigs doesn't really work. You can also pause gigs. I have paused two. I was getting a lot of inquiries for these gigs specifically, so I was wasting a lot of time, especially with people who didn't actually even look at my prices. So they would send me, it was dumb. Never actually converted into orders. And I also just didn't really like that kind of writing. I tried it for a couple and it was okay, but I didn't really enjoy it. So I'm not deleting them. As I mentioned in a previous video, never delete your gigs, but I did pause them so they're not actively available on my profile. And the last one, which I did do for sure, is to change your delivery time. I have also done 7-day delivery period before. I used to do that when I was in college and I was primarily a student, as I mentioned in other videos. I wanted a little more flexibility and also to limit orders at that time so that I could focus on school, but just work freelance on the side to support myself. And then I switched to 5 days when I went full time. But over the years, I have bounced between 5 and 7. I don't think I've ever tried 6. Besides theoretically getting fewer interested clients because those 2 days might just be enough of a deciding factor, it also puts you at the high end of search parameters. So again, as I've mentioned in a previous video, you should be aware of how people search for your gigs. So if they say up to 7 days in the search parameter tab clicker thing, then I am the slowest that they can get out of everyone that shows up for that particular search. And here's what I've noticed. I did 7 days, I think it's been 3 weeks, and I'm very strongly considering going back to 5. More people check in about where I'm at in the process, even though I still have the same exact communication policy. So as I've mentioned in a previous video, I should just like film myself saying that and just slap it in every time I say it. I always go through the order brief right away at the start of the order and I message them confirming that I have received all the information and I will deliver this back as soon as possible within the now 7-day delivery period. Typically with the 5-day delivery period, no one would message me again during, you know, day 1 to day 5 and ask, do I have questions or am I okay or when am I gonna deliver? For whatever reason in that time period, people just trust that yes, I'm still working on it. And with 7 days, people usually are reaching out to me at like day 3 out of 7. So again, even if it was 5 days, I still wouldn't have delivered by now. And they're like, hey, like, do you have any questions? Are you okay? When will I get this? I need this back pretty soon. Like, what's going on? I have noticed that I'm needing to be more proactive with an extra round of communication. And I'm also a little bit worried that it's creating a little bit of customer discord because they feel like it's just sitting. And I think that that's just that 2 days difference. And it's very weird. I hadn't expected to find that, but for sure people feel less settled with the 7-day period unless I schedule another communication round with them, which just takes more time from me. But I didn't expect, no one has complained about the delivery period. Totally okay. They're all like, sure, go ahead and add extra time. We can do 10, 12 days, whatever, fine. I was really expecting people to at least have a thought about it, and no one cares, so that's cool. As I expected, I do have more flexibility in scheduling my orders. Again, it's just the amount of time I have to parcel things out and spread it instead of having everything crammed into those surge moments and having a high volume that's really stressful for a short amount of time. Just those 2 days allows me to spread things out much more manageably. This is silly, but it's also easier to plan my orders ahead of time without counting days because it's just a week. That's silly, but I do like it's just a very clean round number for planning. But the thing I also was not expecting is that it's actually more stressful for me in a way because I have more orders in my queue at a single time. I just have 2 more days worth of stuff piling up, and it's not the end of the world. It's like a mental block. If I have to scroll in my order list, I have too much to do. I have a week to do it, but I have too much to do. There's just more people to keep track of. As I mentioned in a previous video, I always read through all the requirements up front. So those things are kind of churning around in my head. So I'm thinking about them over the next 3, 4, 5 days until I write their order. And now that I have more stuff, I have more stuff churning in my head because there are more open active orders at once. And here's the last one that popped up to me while I was making this list and really thinking about it. Another result is it's kind of a sales psychology perspective of orders in queue. And that shows up on your gig page. It hasn't happened to me recently, but I do remember this happening a lot in college, especially when I was on the 7-day delivery period. Sales in queue can potentially help buyers to see you as being more popular and more active on the platform, because they're literally seeing 3 other people who've already trusted me with their money and their project that could potentially make them also feel more inclined to work with me. But here's the negative. In the past, people have actually messaged me and said like, hey, I see you have a lot of orders in queue. Do you have the time and energy to devote to my project, or are you overbooked? Just something to consider. If you haven't noticed that orders in queue metric on the front of your gig page before, check it out, think about it, consider always what your customer sees as well as what you're actually putting out. All right, that's a lot of jibber jabber for today. Hopefully this is mildly interesting. As always, it's just based on my own personal experience. I'm trying to personally sort through things, manage, set up the business that really works for me the best and is best for not only like the future of how it's gonna look moving forward, but also just my own sanity, peace of mind, comfort. I want to love my job. I want to keep loving my job. And part of that is not being overworked. Wishing you the very best. Please be sure to like and subscribe to this video if you haven't already. You're making my tiny channel grow and I really, really appreciate it. In the meantime, wishing you happy buyers, creative projects, and clear, concise briefs. Let's get back to work.